the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Body language where the bodies do the talking.
Introducing the United States Air Force team, Tech Sergeant Hart Clayton, Sergeant Katie Morford, Captain Dan Flynn, Staff Sergeant Valerie Lejeune, and Captain Michelle Goot, ready for action. Battling for victory against the United States Marines team. Sergeant Rodney Mitchell, Lieutenant Colonel Paul Wilson, Corporal Michael Mack, Staff Sergeant John Bloodworth, and Sergeant Bill Fitzgerald. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud Battle of the Armed Forces. With the star of
thank you so very much. If you've been watching the show, you know this is a very special week on Family Feud. It is our 5-day Armed Services Special. On the 6th day, the championship, who will be called the Armed Services Champions of Family Feud. Right now, we're going to introduce one of our teams who want this trophy badly, the U.S. Air Force.
All right.
Put it right. Let's see, hold it.
I'm gonna take that.
Right. You're ready to take it. Now, Mark. Your rank is?
I'm a technical sergeant.
Technically? Well, then technically, who did you bring with you?
Well, I brought with me today Sergeant Katie Langford. We don't all work together, so sometimes we have to get our family together from all around the United States.
Yeah, that's
so this is Katie Morford with us today.
Excellent. And?
And Captain Dan Flynn.
Welcome.
Thanks.
And Staff Sergeant Valerie Lejeune.
Howdy.
Howdy.
And our mother-to-be, Captain Michelle Goot.
Well, welcome to the show. You're playing for a very fine charity.
Yes, we are. We're playing for the Air Force Aid Society.
The United States Air Force Aid Society.
That's right.
Excellent. Well, you may be in the championship, but there are five gentlemen on that side of the podium that say that they're going to be winners today. They are the United States Marines. Rodney. Sergeant Rodney Mitchell. I'm going to put that right there. Sergeant? Sergeant, who did you bring with you today?
This afternoon I have me Lieutenant Colonel Paul Winston.
How are you, sir?
Corporal Michael Mack.
Nice. Good.
Staff Sergeant John Bloodworth.
Semper Fi.
And Sergeant Bill Fitzgerald.
You are playing for the Navy Marine Corps.
Really excited.
Really,
yes,
fun. Two great charities. Someone will play for the $10,000. I don't know who that will be until we play The Feud. First team to $300 wins the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $10,000. Good luck. We ask 100 people this first question. We put the top 5 answers on that board. Try to find the most popular answer to this very good question. Name something men do when they're having marital troubles. Mark?
See your chaplain.
He says he sees the chaplain. It's not on the survey. Stay here. All right, Rodney. Something men do when they're having marital troubles from 100 people surveyed.
Cheating their wives.
Okay. He says they cheat on their wives. It's number 2 on our survey. All right. Fine answer that you gave, Sergeant.
Thank you.
It just wasn't technically on our survey. But the Marines say cheat on their wives, and everybody yells, good answer! Good answer! Lieutenant, is it Colonel?
Lieutenant Colonel.
Boy, that's pretty powerful stuff.
Hi, Ray.
How you doing?
So far, so good.
Well, you guys are doing well. Now, the question, you got to keep in mind both sides. It's not your personal opinion. It's of the 100 people we surveyed. Something men do when they're having marital troubles.
Drink!
Drink!
Do they?
Drink!
Drink! Number one. Number one. Speaking for the show, I just want to say hi back. What is that when the Marines do that?
It's just an exertion of energy, sir.
Okay. Yep. You know, my father used to do it another way, but what do you say? Something men do when they're having marital troubles.
I say get a divorce, Richard.
Richard!
Right!
Richard! I may be little. Don't get me mad. Show me get a divorce. Did not make the survey. Good try. John? What do you say?
I say they go for a drive.
When men have marital troubles, they go for a drive. Bill, what do you say, sir?
From experience, get separated.
Okay, all right. Thank you for sharing that painful moment with us. Show me separation. There it is, you leave home. $81 in the bank. Rodney, what do you say?
I'll say, Ray, they go out with the fellas.
Go out with the fellas.
Yeah.
Is it up there? Hang with the fellas. No, it is not. Three strikes. Air Force, you can steal this bank if you tell me something men do when they're having marital troubles, Michelle.
They see a marriage counselor.
Marriage counselor, Valerie.
Oh, gosh. They go on a vacation.
Doesn't know Dan. Go on vacation, Dan.
Beat up their wife.
Do what?
Beat up their wife.
Beat up their wives. he's just... Katie?
Work late at the office.
What do you think? What do you think? We're going to go with marriage counselor.
All right, we've heard from beat the wife to go talk about it. We don't say any of these answers are correct. We're just seeing if they're on our survey. You stole the bank if we see a marriage counselor. Not there. The Marines. At that first bank. In our survey, something men do when they're having marital troubles, they do number three. Talk to a... No one said that. And number four. Stay out late. We want you right back here after these messages, but there is a lot more beauty fun on this most special feud. Hurry up! A Marine against the Air Force. The top eight answers on the board. We ask 100 people. Name a magazine you trust. Katie?
Consumer Reports.
Let me see Consumer Reports. Bottom of the survey, seven answers will give you control. Colonel, a magazine you trust.
Time.
Let me see Time.
Yeah,
yeah. It's number one.
Yeah, yeah.
Excellent. Michael?
I say Reader's Digest.
Yeah. It's a fine magazine. Reader's Digest. Yes, sir. Bob. All right. What do you say, John?
I say Newsweek. Yeah.
John, what is your specialty in the Marines?
Right now, I'm a drill instructor down at MCRD San Diego, and I am an 0311 infantry by trade.
You know, I can tell you're a very technically... Would you do me a favor? Just step around here very quickly. We don't have a lot of time, but imagine I was a recruit and you were trying to intimidate me. Turn sideways here. And you were going to get in my face like they do and tell me that I had done something wrong. Maybe I had done it. So quickly, if you could just, like, give me an order, like, real close, nose to nose.
What
like,
have you done? You tell me what you did.
Maybe I didn't do my bed right.
And you're trying to do your bed right.
Yeah, hurry, John.
We don't call it a bed. We call it a rack, recruit. And that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to name a rack. You understand that? I say a rack. You understand me, partner? You understand me?
John, okay. Wait a minute. Come on, Katie. Get over here, Katie. Come on. Come on. Yeah, we're going to kick your butt, John. That was excellent. Excellent. Let me just say, there was spit flying out of his mouth. Things were flying out of there. I didn't know what they were. He said that he trusts. What did you say, though? I'm all shaken up.
Newsweek.
Show it to me. Newsweek. There it is. What do you say, Bill?
Gotta say Sports Illustrated.
Show me Sports Illustrated. Not there. All right. Rodney, I'm still shaking.
Ebony.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
It's a magazine.
Hey, I've been in it. Have you? I was in the carpet of Luther Vandross. Yeah. Show me Ebony Magazine. Not there. All right. Air Force, you might get a chance to steal $50. What do you say?
U.S. News and World Report.
Let me see. U.S. News and World Report. Three strikes. You'll take $50, get in the game if you name a magazine you trust.
TV Guide.
TV Guide. Valerie?
Family Circle.
Family Circle.
Life.
Life?
Cosmopolitan.
Cosmopolitan. Mark,
what do you think?
Out on
what
your
think?
Own.
What do you think?
Family Circle. Family Circle. Life.
What do you say? They're going to take your
life.
Back. You go with life. You're in this game if we see Life Magazine. It's there, number 7. Friends, there are three answers that would have kept you alive. Magazines you trust in our survey, number 2. Good House. It's where they tell you how to keep your rack, really. And number 5. National Geographic. Yes, and number 6.
People.
We're coming back with a lot more feuding fun after this. double the dollar value, and the top seven answers are on the board. Here is the question. Name a formerly all-male sport that now includes women. What do you say, Michael?
Soccer.
Let me see. Soccer. Bottom of the survey. Dan, one answer gives you control.
One more time.
A formerly all-male sport that now includes women.
Softball.
He said softball just at the buzzer. Let's see. Softball.
Yeah.
There it is. All right, we go over here. The Air Force has control. What do you say, Valerie? A formerly all-male sport that now includes women.
Basketball.
Let me see. Basketball. Yeah. Number one answer. $102 up for grabs. Michelle?
Wrestling.
Let me see. Yes, I've seen some. We had women on this show before that could kick Rodney's butt. I'll tell you that.
I don't think so.
Let me see wrestling. Yes, sir. Mark?
It's got to be my favorite pastime, golf.
Perhaps golf. Yes, sir. The bank grows to 150. It's a nice one to steal. Katie? Once all formerly male sport now includes women.
Hockey.
Let me see. Hockey. Boy, that'd be a tough one, meet a girl. So would you lose a few teeth when a puck hit you? Dan?
Tennis.
He says tennis. Good answer.
No, no.
Not on the survey. Valerie, they're going to try to steal $150 if you don't know. Formerly all-male sport, now includes women.
Volleyball.
Yeah.
You're still alive if we see volleyball. All right, Marines. Can you steal with a formerly all-male sport that now includes women? Bill?
Football?
Football. John? Doesn't know.
So,
Michael?
Swimming.
Swimming? Swimming? What do you want to say? Football? Swimming?
Swimming.
You can go with them or out on your own. On your own if you wish. You going on your own?
I'm
going
to go with...
what are you going to do?
I'm going to go with football.
Okay, that's okay.
There are lady players in football?
Oh, yes. Haven't you heard about that?
What team?
Women Lips. Oh, all kind of high school football teams, all that.
All right, okay, all right. Let me see. You got $150 if we see women football players.
No!
The Air Force, take that back. We'll see the two sports that women have gained access to. Number five, auto racing. And number six, horse racing. 200 points for the U.S. Air Force on the way to 300. The Marines have $81. Here we go. Another face-off. Yes, Valerie. The dollar value is tripled, and the top four answers are on the board. Listen to this question very carefully because we're going to move a little quicker. Name an island or group of islands that was involved in World War II. John?
The dog, excuse me.
Judge, did he say it? He was trying. He said the Hawaiian Islands. Let me see. Hawaiian Islands. It is number one. You think of a steal, Valerie. Bill?
That's all.
A little almost more difficult in person, isn't it, Sergeant?
I almost swear. That's why.
That's all right. We can relax here, Bill. We're looking for an island or group of islands that was involved in World War II.
Midway.
Let me see Midway. There it is. This is a big bank with a triple dollar value. Rodney.
Tarawa.
Where?
Tarawa.
Tarawa. Show me Tarawa. The judge knows all of these. All right, Colonel, we're looking for an island or group of islands that was involved in World War II.
The Philippines.
Let me see. The Philippines. Number two. Enough money that if you give me number four, Michael, the Marines are playing for $10,000 for your great charity. What do you say?
Okinawa.
Is it for the game? Okinawa. All right, either team can win now, John. Name an island or a group of islands that was involved in World War II.
Iwo Jima.
Yeah!
The Marines are playing for $10,000 if we see Iwo Jima. Air Force, if you can successfully tell me number four, you will steal the game from the Marines and be one up for our championship series. An island or group of islands that was involved in World War II, Michelle?
Japan.
Japan. Valerie?
Japan.
You betcha. We're going to Japan.
You're going with Japan, and if it's there, you have stolen the bank and won the game on a steal. Is it Japan? Right now, I need two players for $10,000 for the United States Air Force. We'll be right back. Who's playing?
This week, have breakfast with Buzzer, starting off with a plate of hot deals.
$1.
A big bowl of consonants, a big morning stretch.
Whoa, your goodness!
And finish it off with a lot of caffeine. Breakfast with Buzzer, weekday morning starting at 9. It's the most important TV of the day.
We are back in our very special Armed Services Family Feud Week. We put 15 seconds on the clock as the United States Air Force attempts to earn $10,000 for their charity. We ask 100 people name a kind of food you see an ad for on TV and instantly get hungry for.
Spaghetti.
A day when the trash is collected.
Thursday.
An animal you see on Country Road.
A cow.
Something that usually breaks down just after the warranty expires.
Your car.
A brand of motorcycle.
Harley Davidson.
Turn around here. That is five. Let me get close to you. Name a kind of food you see an ad for on TV and instantly get hungry for. You said spaghetti. What'd the survey say? Zero. Not there. The day when trash is collected, you selected Thursday. The survey said 18.
All right, all right.
Name an animal you see on country roads. You said a cow. Our survey said 19.
That's okay.
Good question here. Something that usually breaks down just after the warranty expires, you said. Car. Our survey said, bam!
Oh, there you go. Oh, well.
A brand of motorcycle. You selected the popular Harley Davidson, and the survey said 44 over 100 as we cover those answers. Bring in Captain Flynn. Dan, you look straight ahead. We put 20 seconds on that clock. You are 69 points from the $10,000 you need for your charity. We ask 100 people, name a kind of food you see an ad for on TV and instantly get hungry for.
Soup.
The day when trash is collected.
Wednesday.
An animal you see on country road.
Deer.
Something that usually breaks down just after the warranty expires.
Car.
Right here.
Refrigerator.
Brand of motorcycle.
Harley Davidson.
Right.
Honda.
Turn around. 69 points away. Kind of food you see an ad for on TV and instantly get hungry for, you said? Soup. Our survey said? Zero. Pizza, the number one enticing food on an ad. The day when trash is collected, you said. Wednesday. Our survey said 18. Not a lot of difference in Wednesday and Thursday. Monday, number one day to collect trash. An animal that you see on country roads, you said. A deer. What did our survey say? 18. Inching up. Rabbit was the number one. We are 23 points away, I do believe, 33 points away. Something that usually breaks down just after a warranty expires, you said. Refrigerator. Our survey said 4 only. Car was the number one answer, 29 points away. A brand of motorcycle, you said. Honda. Did 29 people say it for the $10,000? Our survey said...
Strength medicine that helps relieve the stuffy, drippy misery of a head cold. For effective relief, take ActiFed. Use as directed. Get your whole wash fresh and clean without phosphates, Arm & Hammer laundry detergents, liquid or powder. From Arm & Hammer, the freshness experts. Ooh, this Halloween, treat those goblins to a new snack-sized bar none. The candy bar with a light, crispy texture and a rich, chocolatey taste. Hershey's Bar None. Theragran M, multivitamins with minerals rich in B vitamins that help turn food into energy. Theragran M, multivitamins, help unleash your energy. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. Now with 30 flavors, you can serve it every day for a month and never serve the same dish twice. Get all the mystery and adventure of the Clue game for your littlest detectives with Clue Junior for ages 6 to 10 from Parker Brothers. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.